anti-Kejriwal camp is not sitting pretty after last evening's ouster of dissidents Yogendra, Yadav and Prashant Bhushan from the Political Affairs Committee. According to sources, some of the anti-Kejriwal camp are contemplating pressing for the one-man, one-position norm in the AAP. Now, this could be high on the agenda in the National Council meeting happening on the 28th of this month. The National Council is authorized to alter decisions of the National Executive, a meeting of which led, remember, to the ouster of Yadav and Bhushan yesterday. Maha Siddiqui now joining us live with more. Maha, we understand that the AAP, specifically the anti-Kejriwal camp, will in fact be pushing for the norm of the one person, one role norm, specifically in the party. If you can actually elaborate on what that means for the party and more importantly for Kejriwal's role in the party.
Sanjana, in an ideal situation, every political outfit, and it's not just the Aam Aadmi Party, believes that there should be a one-man, one-position norm imposed so that both the party and if they are part of a government in any state or at the center function properly. Remember, this norm was also something that Rahul Gandhi was trying to impose in the Congress party, but often it doesn't take off because political parties are not able to function wherein this norm can be very strictly imposed. However, the way we have seen the Aam Aadmi Party come to life on grounds that it will be an ideal party, that it will fight corruption, obviously there are believers that they should be imposing this norm so that not just the party but the government at Delhi level also functions properly. Now, this is one thing that perhaps could come in handy for those who are looking at maybe ensuring that Arvind Kejriwal doesn't have a complete grip over the party. Now, let me tell you how this will work. At the National Council meeting that is slated for 28th March, which is supposed to be held once a year, perhaps there could be voices that could raise this issue. Now, if this issue is raised, it could mean that in the National Executive, there are some people who are part of the National Executive and who also play a role in the Delhi government. Now, those people offhand, I can mention a couple of them to you. Arvind Kejriwal himself, he's the Chief Minister, Gopal Rai and Manish Sisodia. So that will change the whole constitution in the sense of the members and those pro and anti Arvind Kejriwal within the National Executive itself. And that could work in the benefit of some people who are trying to raise their voice and want changes within the Aam Aadmi Party, particularly the camp, the non-Kejriwal camp that has been pressing for certain changes in the party. So this can come in handy to them. Sanjana, let me again point out once, the National Council cannot alter the decisions of the National Executive. All they can do is change the formation, the members, the group that the National Executive constitutes. They can only change the formation of National Executive.
Fred Maha, you're sort of elaborating what exactly the powers that be that, you know, that could actually take place. So, but furthermore, if you can actually just tell us for our viewers who consists of the anti-Kejriwal camp and what importantly is the likelihood that could in fact happen at this very, very important meeting that's slated to take place on the 28th of this month.
Well, I wouldn't call those people anti-Kejriwal for the simple reason that they have spoken about changes within the Aam Aadmi Party, and it is very obvious now after what happened yesterday in the Aam Aadmi Party National Executive that the people who are viewed as those wanting changes are perhaps somebody like Prashant Bhushan and Yogendra Yadav, and there have been allegations against them that they are working against the party, against Arvind Kejriwal, and that is why we've seen that in the Political Affairs Committee they were asked to step out of it. In fact, they were removed from the Political Affairs Committee. Now, that is the grouping that many label as anti-Kejriwal, but they themselves, and there is an understanding that all they are pressing for is changes within the party. Now, the jury is out whether you view them as anti-Kejriwal or people who are part of the party and want changes. Let me quickly also point out, Sanjana, at this point it's very difficult to understand what these two people are doing, whether they are really disappointed with the decision and would want to quit the Aam Aadmi Party. In fact, we have been outside Prashant Bhushan's residence since morning, but he has not spoken with us. He continues to say that he is not going to speak to the media, to the reporters. He stepped out just about half an hour ago from his house. There were a lot many media persons here. We all tried to stop him, but he said at the moment there is nothing that he wants to say. Future course of action for these people is hard to guess, but for Prashant Bhushan, we have seen in the past during Delhi election campaign that perhaps because he was not happy with the functioning of the party, he was paying more attention to his own work, that is working as a lawyer. So he has that fallback option. However, with Yogendra Yadav, he has made it very clear that he will continue to remain part of the party. He will not let the party split
absolutely
on these grounds. So for him, he is very clear that he is going to continue in the Aam Aadmi Party.
Mahasiddiqui, thank you so much for bringing us that update. All eyes will be on that other camp that has in fact emerged after the Aam Aadmi Party took this major decision and removed two of its founder members, Yogendra Yadav and Prashant Bhushan, from the party's political affairs committee last night. Both Yadav and Bhushan were on a collision course with the party convener and Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal. They were voted out of the PAC, which has been rocked, remember, by dissidents in the recent days. In a showdown in the party's 21-member national executive, supporters of Kejriwal voted out Yadav and Bhushan by 11 to 8 votes. Kejriwal and Mayank Gandhi were not present at the meeting. While one chapter of the bitter feud in the AAP might have ended now, it may not be the end of the story. All through the day yesterday, a desperate bid by the AAP to arrive at a face saver came to a knot. After challenging Kejriwal's absolute writ and AAP's internal democracy, Bhushan and Yadav stayed firm, insisting on not quitting the AAP PAC gracefully, rejecting posts offered to them as a compromise formula. Now, when the party finally moved a resolution to oust them, the rebellious duo wanted a vote.
राष्ट्रीय कार्यकारिणी ने बस ये तय किया है कि मैं और योगेंद्र यादव अभी पीएसी के मेंबर नहीं रहेंगे. ये तो मेजॉरिटी डिसीजन है. जो भी मेजॉरिटी डिसीजन होता है राष्ट्रीय कार्यकारिणी का, वो मान्य होता है.
दिस इज द मेजॉरिटी डिसीजन ऑफ द पार्टी एंड एज डिसिप्लिन्ड मेंबर्स ऑफ द पार्टी वी कंप्लीटली रेस्पेक्ट इट. नो मैटर व्हाट, ना तोड़ेंगे ना छोड़ेंगे, सुधरेंगे और सुधारेंगे. राजनीति बहुत लंबी चीज है, उसमें उठा पटक ऊंच नीच बड़ी सामान्य बात है. आई डोंट ड्रॉ बिग कंक्लूजन्स फ्रॉम वन मीटिंग एंड वन डिसीजन. दीस थिंग्स हैव
इट वाज ऑलवेज वन मैन शो. आई हैड टू से वन टाइम अगो दैट इट हैज बीन अ वन मैन आर्मी. ही वेरी सेंट्रिक, इट्स वन मैन आर्मी, बट फॉर्चुनेटली ही हैड थिंकर्स विद हिम. He had legal thinker in Prashant. He had a strategist in Yogendra. I think he's truly lost a strategist in Yogendra, and a legal brain, and even otherwise very experienced in Prashant. I feel that this difference of opinion hasn't come in the last 1 week or 2 weeks. It appears that it was already there. It used to get revealed sometimes, but they were very protective about it.
The duo had raised a red flag against the continuation of Kejriwal as the national convener. They had also questioned his working style. Now, the decision to remove both of them was not unanimous. As many as 8 voted against it, while 11 voted for. But by successfully removing both of them from the PAC, Kejriwal has essentially strengthened his grip over the party. Now, he himself stayed away from yesterday's meeting, citing poor health, but also avoided engaging with the duo on any of the issues raised by them. The Delhi Chief Minister had apparently insisted on the removal of Bhushan and Yadav from the PAC as a precondition for his staying as the national convener. Kejriwal is now likely to reconstitute the Political Affairs Committee. The opposition, meanwhile, has taken jibes at the AAP.